Welcome to SAP.
Let's take a look at what's new in SAP Business One 10.0 Feature Package 2502. SAP Business One now enables you to create two alerts for monitoring the cumulative threshold of €10,000 related to the one-stop shop regime. For starters, you need to create and set up a user-defined table and three user-defined fields. The alert function then needs to be configured. You can then create two alerts from the queries provided by SAP Business One. One is to remind you to enter the euro exchange rate. The specific date with the missing exchange rate is also indicated. The other is to notify you when the threshold of €10,000 has been reached. The responsible user, for example, the financial manager, is then aware that the supplies to the EU member states are now always subject to OSS reporting and take follow-up actions in the system. You can now use the electronic document import wizard to directly read XML files that are attached to PDF files, such as XML files that are attached to SIGFAIRED PDF files. Some setup is required in sources and selections to use the electronic document import wizard for SIGFAIRED files for the first time. Choose Import Setup to add details to the XPaths tab, including a mapping file for SIGFAIRED. A sample mapping file for SIGFAIRED is available in SAP Note 355-1371. Add information to the Namespaces tab according to the file setup. Choose Upload Files to select your PDF import source. Import Files shows the status of the imported document files and some document details. Match up the details of the imported document file with the master data in SAP Business One. The summary report shows the draft documents that the wizard has created. You can see the resulting AP document drafts in Electronic Document Monitor. In SAP Business One Web Client, you can now use the User-Defined Values feature to effortlessly customize values for a variety of fields in the detailed views of sales and purchasing documents. You can achieve this by using a filtered list or a formula. A filtered list lets you tailor drop-down list options. For example, you have a color field for all product colors but are only selling blue this week. You can use this method to limit the option to just blue, preventing irrelevant choices. Additionally, you can use a formula to autofill certain field values, including date, time, and checkboxes. A formula can include fixed text, arithmetic and logical expressions, and variables of fields from the current document or database. For instance, you can set the remarks field in a sales order to auto-display a customer's balance whenever you change the customer code. Streamline your workflow with user-defined values now. Exciting updates are here for the Linked List Views app, designed to streamline micro-business processes, giving individual end users the ability to easily and quickly create personalized, context-relevant information. Check out the three new submenus under Linkable Objects. First, the List View option. You can link one list view to another or to a general overview view. For example, select a group of accessories in the Items List view to see which are top sellers in the general overview. Next, the Detailed View Header option. This is used for the previously available function. Finally, the Detailed View Rows option. Link from the table section in the detailed view of a business record to a list view or general overview. This is perfect for quickly accessing historical invoice information for specific items when creating sales orders. Streamline your business operations with linked list views today. Discover the power of in-depth data analysis with our new feature. When you select specific data points in a chart, you can now use the button Open in List View in the Details popover to view a breakdown of the selected data in a list view in a new browser tab. This feature allows you to drill down into pre-filtered data for deeper insights and enhanced analysis. You can use this function with the following charts: all charts and chart views of list views, charts within card view cards of list views, and charts within general overview cards with data sourced from list views. Unlock the full potential of your data now. there are a few new apps available in the web client. In the new Chart of Accounts app, GL accounts are organized hierarchically according to drawers, titles, and active accounts. You can select an account to check its details. You can also edit an account, for example, changing its position in the parent article. Account creation and deletion are also available. Another app, Inventory Transfers, is also provided to manage item movements. You can create an inventory transfer by copying from an inventory transfer request. Alternatively, you can start from scratch by specifying items from and to warehouses and quantities. Serial numbers, batches, and bin locations are also supported. The new app, Recurring Journal Entries, and the new detailed definition, Journal Entry Templates, are now here for you to easily view, create, and edit. You can create a journal entry based on them with the new fields template type and template. Selecting a journal entry template fills the lines with defined percentages, while selecting a recurring journal entry instance fills both the general and contents tabs. You can always modify the journal entry before adding it. Thanks a lot for watching. Now it's time to try out these new features for yourself.